Yo, you're turning to the Disposable Hero video podcast dedicated to crate digging. This week we had the opportunity to be in San Francisco, went up to Amoeba, found some amazing tracks in Amoeba. It's one of the biggest record stores I've ever been into. Then we went down to Lower Haight to Groove Merchant, spent some time with Benji and the fellas, got some great stuff, some represses, some originals, some B-sides, it's got some goodies. On this week's session, we're going to cover six things we picked up. JB's Doin' It to Death, James Brown Band. We're going to follow it up with Bloodstone, another one of those records where you just look at the cover and it just grabs you. Chris Hinze Project, 1975. We're going to go into the Elvin Bishop Band. Elvin Bishop group out of San Francisco, Fillmore area. Rhyth-o-Matics, Walking in the Shadow. Great kind of ska record. And then we're going to finish things up with the original Soul Makossa. Really excited to have had a chance to pick this up. It's an original pressing. So we're going to do these every time we're on the road and have a chance to hit the local record shops. Come back, we'll feature some of the tunes that we found so you can get a first glimpse into what these sounds are, what the records sound like. We'll even flip it and show you what we do with some of those samples, not only just from a listening pleasure perspective, but from some of the stuff we're doing for production. We appreciate you tuning in. Let's go.
These are the JB's.
Hit it.
Woo! That's it. We kick things off here with the JB's. James Brown Band. 1973 on the Polydor record.
I call your name, I don't want people to know you're in here.
This is the Doin' It to Death, part one. Backside, this is part two.
Look at him!
Maceo Parker on the horn.
We're gonna have a funky good time.
Clyde Stubblefield on the drums.
We're gonna have a funky good time.
It's a great track.
We're gonna have a funky good time. We're gonna have a funky good time. Let's take him up, Fred. We gotta take you high. Alright. You wanna do it again?
Alright, next up is gonna be Bloodstone. This is one of those records I bought just purely on the cover art alone. The name of this track is called For the First Time. Let's listen to that. Mike Vernon. So I'll choose records a couple different ways. If it's something I've never heard of or never seen before, what I'll do is I'll look at the covers, do mean something. I'll grab that cover and I flip it around, look at the credits, see who's done some work on the album, if they're studio musicians or guest musicians. And with this one, a couple things that jumped out is I know Mike Vernon has produced some really good records. That was the first thing outside of the cover. This record was put together in 1974.
I don't know.
Next up is going to be the Chris Hinze combination. Take a look at this. If you look at that guy, you think, oh, what are we going to get out of this? And John Lee on the bass. And the song is Bamboo Magic. See that coming from that cover. We did not think that this sound was gonna come out of this dude. That Hubert Eves on the Rhodes. That's why I bought this record. Very unassuming. When you look at the cover of that, I would have no idea that was coming out of that dude. Alright, next up is the Elvin Bishop. What? Now hold on a minute. I don't know if you caught that. Let's play it again. As soon as it breaks.
Well, you see.
Fillmore, California. Hear that groove again here. Let's break this down and slow it down. Benji at the Groove Merchant, actually, as I was looking through stuff, first thing he said was, there's a break on that record. I was able to flip it in, and it was literally the first track on that tune, or on that record, excuse me, was that crazy break. So, Benji, good looking out. This next tune comes to us from the Rhyth-o-Matics. The name of the song is called Walking in the Shadows, which is also the title of the album. Got Rudy Ortiz on the percussions. Rudy's done quite a bit of stuff with some of the Calypso records I've got. Just good old-fashioned ska right there. Wilson on the trombone. Ooh. Last but not least, my father-in-law was looking for this on CD when I was out digging around. I had a chance to pick it up. Manu, Dibango, Soul Makossa LP, 1972. A lot of people covered this. Samba Calypso album. It's the original pressing. The studio musicians in the back. It's a great record right here. Here in Soul Makossa. Joby Tobes on the drums. On Atlantic Records.
Mosoma, Mosoma.
That's it, guys. Tuning in. We got probably 80 or 90 records out of that trip to San Francisco. Got some really good stuff. Found some stuff in the discount bin. Got some original pressings. Got the Dak JB's record. It was a huge find for us. Got some unreleased weird single hip-hop stuff I've never heard of. The breaks are just amazing. So we'll continue through this series. We'll pop on a couple more tracks throughout the week. And with that, keep digging. Keep your head bothered. Keep smiling. Peace.
Let's go.